Roe versus Wade's been overturned.
They're taking black jobs.
The Supreme Court has issued a ruling on the extent of presidential immunity from criminal prosecution.
Shocking body camera video released today shows the deadly police shooting.
It feels like my country doesn't love me.
Charlamagne, now is not the time to sit this one out.
It's time for Donkey of the Day.
America is a big reality TV show.
On The Breakfast Club.
Would you rather have the black president or the white president?
You have a problem figuring out whether you're Premier or Trump, and you ain't black.
It's enough.
America has a problem.
Drop on the clues bombs for Taylor Made. Did you miss Taylor just being there high, just producing her little ass off?
She be in there making it.
She be in there high off them edibles, just creating. Go ahead, Taylor. Donkey of the Day for Friday, August 9th goes to CNN correspondent Tom Foreman. Now, I am a person that wants to keep the main thing the main thing. I don't like when folks try to distract me, make me lose focus of what the actual issue is. So it really grinds my gears when I'm watching cable news and I see situations like CNN correspondent Tom Foreman. Now, Governor of Minnesota, Tim Walz, who's now Kamala Harris's running mate, has been getting a lot of smoke the last couple of days. His political and military record are under scrutiny. And Senator J.D. Vance accused him of misleading the country about his veteran status because of some comments he made about why weapons of war should not be allowed on the street. Let's listen to what Tim Walz had to say about that.
Hope woke up like many of you did 5 weeks ago and said, Dad, you're the only person I know who's in elected office. You need to stop what's happening with this. I'll take my kick in the butt for the NRA. I spent 25 years in the Army and I hunt. And I gave the money back, and I'll tell you what I have been doing. I've been voting for common sense legislation that protects the Second Amendment, but we can do background checks. We can do CDC research. We can make sure we don't have reciprocal carry among states, and we can make sure that those weapons of war that I carried in war is the only place where those weapons are at.
Sounds logical to me. I mean, we shouldn't allow weapons that are used in war to be on America's streets, to be in the hands of, civilians. Sounds very logical. We don't want weapons of war on America's streets in the hands of civilians. Sounds like common sense to me, but like I said earlier, J.D. Vance said Tim Walz misled the country about his veteran status. Let's listen to what Senator J.D. Vance had to say.
He has not spent a day in a combat zone. What bothers me about Tim Walz is the stolen valor garbage. Do not pretend to be something that you're not.
Round of applause to J.D. Vance. Round of applause. MAGA Republicans are the best at distractions. They are the best at deflecting. And news networks, for whatever reason, eat out of the palm of their hands because CNN correspondent Tom Foreman decided to fact check what Tim Walz said. Let's listen.
Walz did make a comment speaking to a group. He's done it a couple of times where he has used language that has suggested that he carried weapons in a fighting situation. As you know, with your contact with the military, I know from coming from a military family, there is a difference between being in a combat area, being involved at a time of war, and actually being in a position where people are shooting at you. There is no evidence that at any time Governor Walz was in a position of being shot at, and some of his language could easily be seen to suggest that he was. So that is absolutely false when he said that about gun rights out there.
CNN correspondent Tom Foreman said there is no evidence Tim Walz carried weapons in combat. Same thing J.D. Vance brought to the forefront. Now that is a point of political debate on a lot of these cable news networks. This is Leonard McKelvey, Charlamagne Tha God talking. I have one statement to make about all of this. Who gives a F? Okay, I don't care if Tim Walz did or did not carry weapons of war in combat. You know what I care about? I care about what Tim Walz was actually bringing to the forefront, and that is military-style assault weapons should not be in the hands of civilians. Military-style assault weapons are designed for maximum kills in combat situations, okay? Military-style assault weapons have the ability to fire rapidly and with high accuracy. It makes them beyond dangerous for civilians to have, okay? Dudes is pulling up with choppers, laying down 15, 20 people at concerts, churches. I don't think there's been a setting in America that hasn't experienced a mass shooting at this point, okay? Military-style assault weapons are the reason we have so many frequent mass shootings, okay? Assault weapons are designed for military use. The primary goal is to neutralize the enemy. They're not necessary for self-defense or hunting or any other civilian activity. But Republicans don't want to have that conversation because having that conversation means that they have to come up with some type of common sense gun reform. But that's not going to happen because the gun lobbyists like the NRA are in the pockets of most of these politicians. Why, CNN, are you not talking about that issue? That's the issue. Okay, fact check Tim Walz. Fine. Now, After you fact check them, let's make the main thing the main thing. Let's center the conversation around why weapons of war should not be in the hands of civilians. This is why I applaud MAGA Republicans, the way they can deflect and avoid talking about what we need to be talking about to make cable news talk about what they want to talk about is incredible, okay? And we fall for it every time. I just spoke about this on The Daily Show this week. News networks, y'all control the headlines. Y'all control what the points of debates are. You make the stories. Could we please stay focused? Whoever controls the media controls the minds and controls the narrative. So when it comes to this election, let's make sure the right conversations are being centered. Please give CNN correspondent Tom Foreman the biggest hee-haw. I used to be like that when confronted about certain things in my life.
You would deflect.
Woof, the best. Have you thinking it's you?
You still do when that.
Hey.
You called me raggedy earlier, then gonna tell
I
me.
I did not.
Yes, you did. Then gonna say, I'm just country. No, I understand I grammar. No. And when you say y'all, it's inclusive.
No, I was.
About to lie. Go ahead, lie.
I gotta take my vitamins.
Mm-hmm. You're running your blood pressure up over there trying to lie.
I don't take my statin until 6 p.m.
Mm-hmm. Envy,
where you
at?
That Donkey Today.
Donkey Today is sponsored by renowned personal injury attorney Michael the Bull Lamisoff. Don't be a donkey when you need a fighter on your side. If you're ever injured, go to michaelthebull.com. That's michaelthebull.com. And when you mess with the bull, you get the horns.
Wake that ass up.
In the morning.
The Breakfast Club.